Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion for the Amiga. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Just read a whole bunch of things on this by using this guy's network or his Wi-Fi or something like that. And I kind of think this is similar to some console games and maybe some PC games as well, in that certain events won't happen until you do something else. So now that we've read these messages and posts and stuff on the network, maybe now something will happen. So we're off in the southwest corner. I've seen this little girl over here who kept running away as soon as, you know, before we could catch her. Maybe she will be here? Okay, so it's ahead and to the left, so that's where we were. Okay. As you walk these dirty streets, your eyes suddenly alight on a simple escapee girl who is holding her little baby. You cannot explain why. She's just one among the hundreds of those poor and homeless people, but you sense something weird about her and her baby. Anyway, perhaps your senses are playing games with you. Yeah, the baby's... Well, her arm's all scraped up. Unless those are wires or something like that, because everyone's technologically enhanced. But the baby's skull is shaped very strangely. Can we talk? I have no intention to talk to you. By Lavender's name, I ask you to leave me alone with my baby, please. Well, that's a fine how do you do. Let's ask about the baby. Please leave me alone. I already have more than enough trouble. I don't need you to make even more. At least she's walking like that. It's like her back hurts or something. We ask about her back? Alright, that's like a general response. As always, we have this scan function. Can't scan who's right in front of us. Go into combat. Attack. You know what I also realized too? I don't remember where I saw it. I think I was going through the manual again. Maybe that's where I saw it. We can analyze things. So if we go like that, selected item, not sure if this will work. Oh yeah, tiger claws, cool. We got all stats on the weapon. User classes, Mediator, Anchorite, Knight, and Assassin. Weapon attributes. Average wounding is 18. Range is 2. Secondary value modifiers. Look at that. Operation time. Physical action time. Physical attack and defense. Even as a defense. Range defense. Unfortunately, to take a look at everything, I think this is the way you have to do it. That was a wasted effort. Nothing happens. Oh, I was going to use the item? Oh, we can use items on people. Okay. Oh, I want to analyze everything. I hope you guys don't mind. It didn't show up in the bottom, too, until I hit Analyze, Desert Hood. All classes can use Speed Factor 60. Okay, 5% physical protection. It affects against temperature, organic materials, unorganic radiation, extreme sound, and pathogens. You figure the helmet would help more against extreme sound, but I guess it doesn't cover your ears that tightly. That's pretty interesting. You can use items on these people. I thought you'd have to download it, or upload it rather, because to talk to them you have to go into the network. So I figure to interact in any way you have to go to the network. So you upload something to give it to them. But that's not the case. I recommend you to try that item somewhere else. That's not what I was trying to do. Alright, so the crossbow, I think we have. Or is it the shotgun I put? It's the crossbow. Viper 17 crossbow. Alright, mercenary, an assassin, and anchorite can use. And that is all. Average wounding is 18. Oh, you need a minimum of 30 perception to even use the thing. There's no fear there. My perception's pretty good, I think. I mean, for the anchorite, I wasn't really focusing on that. Let's see, just the mental values. I used a crossbow on her. Alright, so... Oh, what'd I do? Did I put it? Where'd it go? Hey, there are no items. Yeah, why not? What, I switched hands? Oh! Okay, that makes sense then. Did I have the glove still in my hand, or did that take the glove off? I switch it. I don't know. Alright. Gonna analyze this. Not too many things. I mean, they have a lot of duplicate items. Stabilizer glove. Knight, mercenary, and assassin. Speed factor 95%. Does it speed things up? Does it make you... Range actions. Okay, for physical? Physical. These are like negatives. Yeah, I'm not sure what's up with that. I should get analyze more than one thing at a time, like, and have to keep going back and forth like this. Uniform tunic. Are these zeros? Because the 8 is more defined. This is all blurry. 0.80 kilograms? Physical protection plus 5%. Oh, it helps a small amount on all these things, especially high temperature and low. And then these stealth boots. And it's not giving us that much, like, valuable information, but it's interesting to see. Only Anchorite and Assassin can use the stealth boots. Interesting. Speed factor 110%. So speed factor 110%, is that right? So why is it minus 10 for action time? Helps the most against electricity, but not that much. I wonder if we'll find lots of cool new gear. I hope so. At some point. Alright, so here we've got some different items. The same desert hood, stabilizer glove. I want to look at the carbine, uniform tunic we've looked at. The military boots we have not, because he had the stealth boots. So let's look at this thing. Carabine or carbine, I think. Maybe just supposed to be carbine, maybe. And a typo, because we've seen a few of those. Typos, that means. Speaking of typo, as I'm saying that, I'm making a typo. Some kind of self-realizing future or something. Speed factor 150%. Only knight and mercenaries can use it. Average wounding is 28, so this is pretty good. Better than the crossbow. Not surprisingly. Minus 10% range action time. Hmm. Beep boop beep boop. Here. Have a gun. No. And then these military boots I want to look at. .65 kilograms, 120% speed factor, mediator, psionic knight, and mercenary can use them. They're great against temperature and electricity. Well, relatively great anyway. I'm glad she doesn't want that, because we need our boots. That's a different helmet. A steel combat helmet. Same stuff. .10 kilograms, speed factor 70%. All users can wear it. I'm surprised. So wait a second. Oh, it's great against we need more of these. Well, it's a detriment to electricity. But everything else is pretty good. If we find some more of these, definitely want to switch them up and get rid of the other helmets. Let me just look again. I know the other stats are better. It's just this, and they're heavier. I mean, I don't know if there's any weight, like, encumbrance in this. I don't think there is. Speed factor 70%. Okay. Alright, so look at physical protection. What's the difference between physical defense and physical protection? Really? Is it protection the same as defense and vice versa? Alright, so physical protection is 15%. We have all this stuff, which I know is better, except for electricity. What was that again? Sorry, guys. One fifteen percent. I know I'm having trouble remembering that. Plus 15, right? Okay. Plus 15. Oh, that speeds it up. Okay. The other mouse button. Okay. Alright, so 15%. And now if you compare this with the desert hood. It's a physical protection, but here we don't have defense. We don't have physical defense and physical protection, it's just physical protection. And the resistance modifiers are much lower. And not as much of them. I guess the ones not listed are like 0%. Because that other helmet had a lot more resistances listed. So all this stuff is the same. Well, these are light leather boots, that's different. I definitely want to look at stuff in the backpack too. We'll probably be up to the backpack next... the next item. Oh god. You know what's tripping me up? I keep trying to use analyze with a Z, and I know it's not spelled that way, because this is, you know, European. They like S's a lot more, they don't use Z's for hardly anything. 105% speed factor, I mean, generally speaking, anyway. Yeah. Okay. Really low modifier for any of that stuff. But I'm sure it adds up. Six lives. No. I messed it up. Six senses, nine lives. I love it. It's all the same stuff. Well, except for the backpack. Alright, well, I looked at the claws. How about these arrows? The first time looking at ammunition, so this is probably gonna look a little different. Weapon attributes, 0. So all the attributes are coming from the weapon itself. All classes can use. Oh, that's it. Well, all classes can use the ammo, but I don't know about the crossbow. We probably can. You don't want my ammo? Well, that's on you. The med kit, maybe? Alright, let me look at a few of these other things. Before I start, let me look at the bayonet. Just... I'm gonna end up giving it to the back to the person, the wrong person. Because I think that's how you also switch gear to different party members. 0. Okay. I want to look at the nunchucks. Nunchaku. Mediator, psionic, and assassin can use it. 18 wounding. Range 2. I thought this says wolves. I'm like, minimal required wolves? How many wolves do you need? No, values. Dexterity, speed, and concentration. Mental action time. Huh. I don't know why you would need a mental action time for... nunchucks. Oops. That's the only way I know to clear that. Action points required to move the selected item. Okay, so if you're in combat, this is, takes time to move it. Makes sense. What about the symbol of Rexhelion? .50 kilograms. A speed factor 50%. I guess it's if you want to use it. Throw it at somebody? I don't know. It'd be nice if there was like some like lore, little like tidbits of info. Oh, you took it. Driven by a very strange idea and all those rumors you recently heard, you remove the Rexhelion symbol from within the pleats of your clothes. As the baby's gaze catches the symbol, you're immediately stunned by a telepathic message, as powerful as it can be. The message is a word, only one single word, asylum. Then, as his mental conditioning is now completed, the baby falls into a deep, unconscious slumber. Oh, she's gone. Okay. The baby told me asylum. Telepathically. I'm gonna write it down. So I don't forget. In exchange for the necklace. Well, one of us are missing a necklace. I guess it's alright. We've got a bunch. Well, there's one thing we didn't look at. The med kit. I guess you wouldn't have taken the med kit either. That would be... I was, like, leading up to that. I'm like... Maybe you guys need some help, and we'll give them the med kit. That's why I saved that for last, but took the necklace, so... Oops. I'm hitting E. That's moving me. W. Haha! That's cool. It's responding to WASD as well as the arrow keys. Because I've been using the arrow keys. I use a Thrustmaster gamepad type device. Alright. Let's analyze the medkit and then we'll head on our way. Medical supply kit, 4.10 kilograms, speed factor 300%. That's good, right? All classes can use. So Killdozer is our de facto medic, for whatever reason. Requires dexterity and intelligence, 30. Alright. Doesn't say like how much it heals for or anything like that. Thought it would. Alright, where are we? And what is left to do? Up here, all the way at the end, we have the... his name is Yahil. He's a bionecron. See if anything new here. I have a feeling we're going to the... more the eastern section, because it was a... Since your last visit, the place has been brutally looted and closed. Well, that's interesting. Not just looted. Brutally looted. Where's the... Right away down, okay. Alright, so we're going... all the way up. South. North. Wait. Are we at the corner already? So I want to go east. Not hand, because I'm not there. I'm gonna figure out where I am on the map on my other screen. So I can go north and south. I think I have to go, yeah, west, and then it continues north, yes. Yes, yes. Very good. Alright. I'm gonna go visit that other guy, the... Yeah, was he a Cybern? The dead end there. We go this way. Alright, we're in the northern section, and it's gonna tell us we're at the main street or crossroads or something like that. Main street. Same. He was looted as well. What the hell's going on in here? Oh, we're supposed to go east and then north. Yeah. Back in the main street. There's only one other place to go. Maybe since they brutally looted the other shops, maybe they will have broken into that one shop that we couldn't get into. Oh no, we want it east. north. East. Eastern quarter. I'm gonna save, because what if there's a fight? Because last time we were over here, it said people were becoming agitated and like, we had a bad feeling or something like that. So let's save. Beep boop boop. It does that whenever we make a new save. It's only gonna do that four more times. Cause, it will have used up the slots and it'll be saving over. It doesn't do that when you save over for some reason. Alright, so we're at this corner. Ahead. We're heading west, yeah. Whoa. You are facing a serious street riot. The wild, enraged crowd is led by some young reptiloid priests of a strongly negative entity called Vitriol. The appearance of these ill-famed and perverse priests is always very likely in similar situations. They are unpredictably violent and chaotic, so it is not surprising they're enjoying the confusion. But beyond the rapidly growing tension, you can clearly feel something more frightening. These people, even the priests, are not in full control of themselves. There is a hidden power behind their blazing eyes. Is there now? Battle situation. You cannot leave. What if I try to heal the guy? Well, the obvious thing is to switch the battle. But what if we try to talk to this person instead? Let those wonderful weapons speak for themselves, cowardly scum. Really? Scan? Nothing. I guess that works in combat, because always when there's someone in front of us, it says there's no one there. We have nothing in common, weakling. Our law is simple. Fight or die.
You fight or you die.
Alright, we're going to combat then. You cannot switch to the movement screen during battle, okay? Equipment, map, battle. The battle begins with action order coordinations and stuff. Okay, so this is us. This is us six here.